Assalamualaikum dear doctors. In this video, I am sharing GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease management according to NICE guideline. The management of GERD divided into two treatment: first non-pharmacological, then pharmacological treatment. In case of non-pharmacological treatment, these are review the feeding history, then reduce feed volume if excessive for current weight, small and frequent feeds, slightly probed position whilst feeding. Do not use positional management to treat gastroesophageal reflux in sleeping infants. Trial of thickened formula, example rice, starch and cornstarch. Thick and easy, caravel, nutilis. If family history of atopy, presence of eczema, pain on feeding, consider trial of extensively hydrolyzed formula for 4 weeks. Consider amino acid formula if partial response or response after response. If breastfeed, trial of maternal cow's milk exclusion for 2 weeks minimum. In case of obese patient, weight management, healthy lifestyle choices. Now I am repeating non-pharmacological treatment of GERD. These are first review feeding history, then reduce feed volume if excessive for current weight, small and frequent feeds, slightly probed position whilst feeding. Do not use positional management to treat gastroesophageal reflux in sleeping infants. Trial of thickened formula, example rice starch, corn starch. Thick and easy, caravel, nutilis. If family history of atopy, presence of eczema, pain on feeding, then consider trial of extensively hydrolyzed formula for 4 weeks. Then consider amino acid formula if partial response or relapse after response. If breastfeed, trial of maternal cow's milk exclusion for 2 weeks minimum. Obese patient, weight management, healthy lifestyle choices. Now pharmacological treatment of GERD. Treat symptoms but does not reduce number of reflux episodes, then trial of alginate, Gaviscon infant therapy for 2 weeks. H2 receptor antagonist ranitidine easy to administer for 4 weeks. Then proton pump inhibitor PPI for 4 weeks. These are omeprazole, lansoprazole, esomeprazole. Refer if no response to treatment or recurrence on stopping treatment. I am again repeating pharmacological treatment of gastroesophageal reflux disease. Treat symptoms first but does not reduce number of reflux episodes, then trial of alginate, Gaviscon or Gaviscon infant therapy for 2 weeks. Then H2 receptor antagonist ranitidine easily to administer for 4 weeks. Then proton pump inhibitor PPI for 4 weeks, omeprazole, lansoprazole, esomeprazole. Refer if no response to treatment or recurrence on stopping treatment. So first we give Gaviscon or Gaviscon infant, that is 2 weeks. Next H2 receptor ranitidine 4 weeks. Then proton pump inhibitor 4 weeks. 2 weeks, then 4 weeks, then 4 weeks. If after that not response, then recurrence of stopping treatment and refer. Remember, domperidone no longer recommended for children age 12 year. Okay. Now what are the investigation we do for GERD? These are requested by specialist. And these are 24-hour pH study which detects acid reflux episodes only. Next, 24-hour pH and impedance study detects both acid and non-acid reflux episodes. Then upper gastrointestinal contrast study or barium swallow. This detects anatomical defects, hiatus hernia, malrotation and pre-surgery. Then flexible upper gastrointestinal endoscopy and biopsies. This detects inflammation, eosinophilic esophagitis. I am again repeating investigation of gastroesophageal reflux disease. These are requested by specialist. First, 24-hour pH study which detects acid reflux episodes only. Then 24-hour pH impedance study detects both acid and non-acid reflux episodes. Then upper gastrointestinal contrast study or barium swallow which detects anatomical defects, hiatus hernia, malrotation and pre-surgery. Then flexible upper gastrointestinal endoscopy and biopsy. Endoscopy and biopsy detects inflammation, eosinophilic esophagitis. And surgical treatments are refractory patients, fundoplication, laparoscopic or Nissen, and surgical jejunostomy. Now again repeating the surgical treatment of GERD. These are refractory patients, fundoplication, application, example laparoscopic or Nissen, then surgical jejunostomy. This is all about GERD management according to NICE guideline. Please do subscribe and share my channel, everyone. Thank you.